Hey, what's up guys? Prestige here, and today I'm bringing you your very first look at the brand new Extinction map, Exodus. This is also the final episode for Extinction for Call of Duty Ghosts, and it is a great way to end this whole thing. I'm not going to be showing you the final cutscene here. I'm not going to show you the final battle. I want you guys to experience that for yourself. For those of you like hardcore Extinction fans, you're going to love this map. A lot of you, including myself, knew that having that drill with you was always just such a drag. Like, it was that main priority of having to constantly protect the drill, constantly lug it around from hive to hive. That is cut out completely. You don't have to worry about that. The linear map design has also been cut out. You have more freedom of choice when you want to choose where to go. So you can choose to go left, right, or straight and forward when you first originally spawn by opening doors. And once you open these doors, you get a time limit, and basically what you have to do is fend off the aliens, or the cryptids. And that's another thing. There is so many different types of cryptids on this map, it's gonna make your head spin. But it works really well. So you have your scorpions, your hunters, you know, your regular just cryptids from Point of Contact and all the other maps that we've played before. But then you also have sort of like a mixture of your gargoyles, your fireflies, you have your rhinos, you have your mammoths. You have basically every type of cryptid on this map, or a lot of different types of cryptid. Not every single one is here, but you have a ton of different types of cryptids. And you also have the ancestor, which acts like a mini boss. But the thing that I want to point out is, in order to kill this thing, you have to have the NX-1 Disruptor, which sort of acts like a, or which sort of is like the wonder weapon of this map. We had the Venom X, which everyone was like, oh man, the Venom X. This is similar to the Venom X. It's not the same thing, and you don't have to pick up ammo for it, or you don't have to pick up rounds for it off the ground. It regenerates itself over time, so you have a total of 10 shots in the weapon, and you can singly fire those at enemies. It does do decent damage, but it's not something that I would suggest sticking with because the rate of fire is really slow. But the thing is, you're going to need this to take out the Ancestor, because what happens is, once you're shooting at the Ancestor, it will create this bubble around it, and it will be protected. You will not be able to shoot it. But if you use the NX-1 Disruptor, by holding down the trigger instead of just shooting it over and over again, you can create this huge like orb that goes and disrupts the entire field that the Ancestor is making. So it drops its shield and you can shoot it then, and that's how you kill it. The cool thing about that is, if you get too close to the Ancestor, it'll actually pick you up and like choke you in the air. It's really, really creepy, but it's also really, really cool. So you have to make sure you are ready for battle when you go up against this thing, because you're gonna have to constantly worry about the Ancestor, and then you're also going to have to worry about the other cryptids that are constantly attacking you. And the worst situation is when you have rhinos and mammoths coming at you, and you also have the Ancestor right there, because it has a lot of health. It takes a little bit to take down, but if all of you are focusing fire on it, you can take it out pretty quick. But if it's only like one person focusing fire on it, it's going to take a little bit of time. So the other thing is that you have to worry about, these ancestors can actually leave the map. So if you don't kill it in time, it can go away and come back and haunt you at a later date. I guess you would say at a later time. It can come back and haunt you and actually try to get you again. So try to take those out as soon as possible. Another thing is, I was told that it is a lot easier to earn teeth on this map, which is a really good thing because there's a lot of new stuff in the Armory. So if you want to see that Armory video, I will link it down below in the description. The Armory has been just engorged with a ton of new things, a ton of new upgrades, and a lot of them cost a lot of teeth, but they're very, very powerful upgrades. So if you want to be the main dude in Extinction that everyone relies on, you're gonna have to save up your teeth. I think the one most expensive thing was 1,000 teeth, and I don't know if that's going to be changing at all. But yeah, that's the thing that I was just thinking about. Like, 1,000 teeth, man, it takes so long to get teeth already. Another thing that I want to point out is the gameplay you're watching is a developer's build, so things look a little bit differently here, or things look a little bit different here. You know, similar to the NX-1 Disruptor. The NX-1 Disruptor is actually a little bit different than what you're going to see in the final. Here you don't see like the blue laser that it creates inside the capsulated part, but in the final version you're going to see like a blue laser inside when you finally do charge up the thing, which is really cool. But anyway guys, I'm going to let some more gameplay here roll out for you. I just am pretty satisfied with how this map is. I really truly enjoy it. I really hope you guys enjoyed this gameplay as well. If you did, please consider leaving a like down below. And like I said earlier, hit that subscribe button to stay up to date. I upload every single day, and I don't think you guys want to miss out on what I upload over the course of the next few days. So until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace.
Let's get that generator started!